Fall at Michigan State University means football, but before Saturday's Notre Dame game, it also meant Autumnfest 82, where business leaders and graduates of MSU's College of Agriculture and Natural Resources met for their annual pregame party.
That started back in 1975, when we were originally a chapter then of the MSU Alumni Association, and it's been progressing ever since. Our first Autumnfest was held behind Shaw Hall. We had 480 people, and last year we had 2,200, and this year it looks like about 2,000 people again. We're excited about it.
Well, Bob, how the heck do you get 2,000 people to come back to Michigan State University?
Well, I think you let them know that they can come and get some good food and some good fellowship and just a lot of fun, and they look forward to that kind of a get-together. Down to the center of the field house here on the gym floor, you've got the basketball court covered with exhibits, and these exhibits are put on by the department exhibits and the clubs, and the two fraternities are with the College of Ag. Then along the back perimeter, you've got some food products that have been donated by some of our commodity groups in the state, such as the Michigan Cherry Producers and the Bean Commission and the Apple Commission and the Michigan Fish Producers, and the Department of Agriculture is trying to promote this here Say Yum to Michigan type of thing, and we set our Michigan food products on parade, and these people are actually passing out some good samples of their product.
Top political figures attended Autumnfest to show their support for agriculture and agricultural research in helping Michigan's economic recovery.
Well, this is the harvest time of year. Kind of reminds you that Michigan is a great state, have great agriculture and very productive. And we're all experiencing great harvest this year, almost too great because it's hurting the prices, but it's nice to be able to have a good harvest.
Obviously, the tight money, severe credit problems are enormous. The state may be able to fill in with some form of credit assistance to see farmers through this transition. Export policies. We need a stable program of exporting our commodities for foreign markets. I think the governor can help in that by using the Washington office to help promote exports. They've never done that. By working with embassies in Washington and foreign purchasers, they've never done that. By bringing potential buyers into Michigan, that has not been done. We're going to do it. I also think the governor can help expand the contribution and financial support of Michigan State University's School of Agriculture and the Cooperative Extension Service. Finally, I think there has to be a general debate and discussion about the fact that agriculture, forest products, tourism, agribusiness are all major industries in Michigan which show tremendous potential for expansion and jobs.
You want to look back, always go for the research, always go for doing it better. Marketplace is efficient. We'll continue to adapt. If we were processing more here, if we were finding ways to ship from here, if we were opening up world markets, if the governor was serving as an ambassador for marketing in world markets, that type of thing, more aggressively, now those things will work out, but never look back. Got to have progress. You got to look forward. We'll find better ways, other ways, more productive ways, and in the long run, society will adjust. The carburetor adjustments will be made from time to time, and it'll be in the best interest of society.
Do you feel that an automobile state can be hand-in-hand partners with agriculture?
They're going to have to be, because the automobile industry is never going to be as large as it was, although it's still a significant portion of our industry. Going forward, the great potential in terms of exponential growth, the small and medium-sized business, high technology, forestry and agriculture.
We have to learn to produce more food on less land, produce it better, faster, and cheaper. And it isn't a one-year or ten-year deal. I mean, we're gambling with the life of the whole planet. And a university like Michigan State is a leader in innovations in agriculture, and we need every one of them we can get.
While politicians may not agree on all issues, they were unified in their support for Spartan football.
Are you headed for the game this afternoon?
Absolutely. And we're going to win.
I look forward to it, including today. And I will always be a loyal Spartan fan, even now when they're losing. I root for them, and I'm proud of it, very proud of it.
I don't think Notre Dame comes to Michigan State thinking that they're the real threat that they are. Michigan State's better than Notre Dame thinks. And frankly, it could be a real surprise for the Irish, and I would hope it is.
Green and white! Here I am! If yelling will do it, we'll win.
But the Spartans weren't able to break Notre Dame's 8-point lead during the last half of the game. David Brown reporting, East Lansing.